For more than two decades, many of Turkey's 160,000 Christians found a home in Andrew Brunson's church in Izmir, Turkey, on the Aegean coast southwest of Istanbul. Then came the coup. In July of 2016, military forces attempted to overthrow Turkey's government, led by President Recep Erdogan, and Erdogan and his forces responded with a vengeance.
President Erdogan just really released a dragnet and started arresting and detaining anyone he deemed a threat, which of course was anyone he deemed a Gulenist, but would also include Christians.
Gulenists are followers of Fethullah Gulen, a former imam who has lived in the United States for the last 20 years. Erdogan has tried to get Gulen extradited to Turkey for much of his time in office, and many of Brunson's supporters are connecting the dots between that battle and Brunson's arrest.
Do we know that Reverend Brunson's arrest was connected to the post-coup crackdown?
President Erdogan made it very clear at the end of last year that he is using Pastor Brunson as a bargaining chip when he asked to trade him for Fethullah Gulen, who is a cleric living in Pennsylvania and the cleric that he blames for the failed coup attempt. Clearly, Turkey is wanting to get something from the United States, and they're using Pastor Brunson to do that.
Put more bluntly,
this is a sham trial.
After 18 months in prison, Brunson was finally charged in this court in Turkey on April 16th, and his home state senator, Tom Tillis, was there but was unconvinced by what he saw.
Are you aware of any evidence against Pastor Brunson?
Well, certainly none that was presented today. I mean, a lot of it are a loose set of secret witnesses and things that I know in my court of law, I don't see how it connects together with any coherent charge. I participated in the hearing all day today, and I'm even more convinced that he has a compelling case to be released.
Erdogan was recently quoted as saying, if the U.S. wants Pastor Brunson released, it should look at its own actions. Those actions now include sanctions from the U.S., but North Carolina Congressman Mark Walker thinks we can do a lot more.
We have a lot of leverage. Turkey is one of the 29 NATO countries, but they're acting like an authoritarian regime, a rogue nation here. So I think we need to continue to turn up the pressure and make sure that we're sending a very clear message to Erdogan that we will not tolerate such behavior.
Brunson is now charged with aiding groups Erdogan believes were behind the coup, and Brunson's American lawyer is beginning to think this incident is no longer just a legal case.
Do you feel optimistic?
I want to feel optimistic that Turkey will do the right thing, yes. Do I think or expect that Turkey is going to have a fair trial for Pastor Brunson? I do not. I believe that it's going to take diplomatic measures and the prayers of people around the world.
The diplomatic pressure began with tweets about the situation from both President Trump and Vice President Mike Pence, and more significantly, with this letter from 66 U.S. senators demanding Brunson's release. Bob Buckley, Fox 8 News.